Sorry. Okay, so after check the homogeneity, if it's homogeneous, second thing they will do what? They do experiment. They collect data. They get the data. Okay. They get the data for, they do experiment. They get the data for mass and acceleration. Do we get the same force? Then this is the second step. Okay. If data is not really obey the equation's order, then we say it's wrong. Okay. The first step we do is homogeneity. Okay. For example, you see the one equations here. B equals to U plus 480. Is it correct? Of course, V equals U plus 80, right? Not 480. Eh? This V equals U plus 480. Is it homogeneous? You have to check. Check your left-hand side, V. V, on your left-hand side. Eh? Left-hand side, is it homogeneous? Left-hand side, what is the unit for left-hand side? Left-hand side unit is, for V is what? Is meter per second. Okay. Check the right-hand side unit. Right-hand side unit is what? U. Because it's plus, you have to find the unit separately. U unit and 480 unit must be same. U, what is the unit? Also meter per second. Okay. 480, what is the unit? 480, what is the unit? A is meter per second squared because acceleration. Time is second. So end up getting what? Meter per? Okay. So the left-hand side unit is meter per second. The right-hand side unit also, both of them meter per second. Therefore, this equation, the first equation, is homogeneous. First equation is homogeneous. Okay, homogeneous. But when we go bring it to check the data, physically does not guarantee. It does not guarantee physically correct. That means, of course, when you bring this equation and calculate the movement, this equation is wrong. Okay, but is it homogeneous? Yes, it's homogeneous. Okay, check the second one here, the extra term. For example, this equation, T equals 2 pi root of L over G. Is it homogeneous? Is it this equation is homogeneous? Check left-hand side, LHS. What is the unit for LHS, left-hand side unit? Anyone? Left-hand side, what is the unit?
S minus 1.
So, second, left-hand side is second, period. Check the right-hand side unit. What is the right-hand side unit? What is the unit right-hand side? 2 pi root of L over G. 2, do you have any unit? It's a constant, don't have unit. Pi, do you have any unit? Radian not counted actually. Radian is actually a ratio. So the unit belongs to L and G. So put L and G unit. Root, you have to carry on. Okay. L, what is the unit? Meter. Gravity, what is the unit? Meter per S negative 2. So what do you get eventually? You get S. You get second. So left-hand side, second. Because right-hand side also the unit becomes second. Therefore, is this homogeneous? Yes, this equation is homogeneous. Okay, so this is how you check homogeneity. Every equation before go for testing, you must check the homogeneity. Why you need to check the homogeneity? That is the first step to validate an equation. Okay, so let's say Newton give F equals to 3ma. 3ma. Is this equation homogeneous? Anyone? Is it homogeneous? F equals to 3ma. Is it homogeneous? Check left hand side. What is the unit for left hand side? Left hand side unit will be still kgms negative 2, right? Still will be kgms negative 2. How about right hand side? What is the right hand side unit? Still will be kgms negative 2. So this equation is homogeneous. It's homogeneous. But of course, physically not correct. But is it homogeneous? Of course, it's homogeneous. So you check, this is called checking homogeneity. Okay? So based on that, so another one formula. Work done equals to gain in kinetic energy, gain in gravitational potential energy. Is this equation is homogeneous? Work. What is work? Work is force time distance. So what the unit is, force is kgms negative 2, distance is meter, kgm2s negative 2. This is your left-hand side unit. check the right hand side unit. Right hand side unit, you got two. You have to check them separately because it's plus. Plus means you have to check the unit here and unit here must be same. So kinetic energy, what is the unit? Recall back the formula, half mv squared. So m is kg, ms negative 1, so kg m 2, s negative 2. Okay. The half, which has no unit, no need to include. GPE, mgh, so kg ms negative 2 meter, so also kg m 2 s negative 2. So all terms have the same base unit, so therefore they say to be homogeneous. Okay, so homogeneous means first step to prove that it's what do you call its validity. Okay, now we come back to this equation. Okay, check which equation is correct. 1 minute for you. Check for me. Which equation is possibly correct? How do you check them? You never seen these four equations before. How to check which is could be correct? So you check the homogeneity. Please check the homogeneity for these four equations. Which one is homogeneous? So how do you check homogeneous? The left hand side unit and the right hand side unit must be same. Okay. First one. Is it homogeneous? I'll give you 1 minute now. Please check. Calculate for me. Check the homogeneity for this four equation. Tell me which one is correct equation. V equals to root of G lambda. G gravity. Lambda wavelength. V is speed. Rho is density. G is gravity. Yeah. You have to know all the units. Give you 1 minute. Come on. Which equation is homogeneous? Okay, so the first equation, second equation, third equation, fourth equation. Which equation is homogeneous?
The first one.
Yes, should be first one. First one is homogeneous. On the left, you get meter per second. Of course, on the right also, you'll get meter per second. The other three formulas, it's not homogeneous. Okay. Gravity, what is the unit? Meter per density, what is the unit? Kg per meter cube. Yeah, so these three are not homogeneous. So answer is first one, okay. Homogeneity.
Okay. So G is ms minus 2, right?
G is, oh sorry, thanks. Ms minus 2, homogeneity. Thanks.
Okay.
So let's go on. So this is called homogeneity. Okay, before we go to this, I'll be changing one file to another. So the Word file also have some questions about homogeneity. Okay, check, is this formula is homogeneous? You can see the question, Lambda equals to root of V over lambda. Is it homogeneous? You must start saying left hand side what you need. And you must say right hand side what you need. Check the units. The same, then it's homogeneous. So homogeneous?
No.
No. Left hand side, what is the unit? Meter. Right hand side, what is the unit?
Square root m.
Square root
m.
M. Oh yeah, m frequency. What is your unit? So second,
S minus one.
So yeah, got square root of m. So they are not homogeneous. So they are not homogeneous. Okay, good. So you must start with left hand side, right hand side. If not same, you see not homogeneous, not valid. Pointless doing experiment by using this formula. This formula is already wrong. If a scientist come out with this formula with a lot of theory, but this is technically failed the first step. Okay, not homogeneous. Okay. So this is the first part. Let's we move on. Okay, next, what you need to recall is, of course, you've seen just now, prefixes. You have no prefixes. So these all prefixes you have come across, right? Okay, what is the use of prefixes? To write the big numbers with the very little digits. That's prefixes, right? And instead of like say 5 billion, we don't want to write like 9 zeros at the back. So we just put 5 × 10⁻⁹. Or we can say just 5 giga or something. Oh, sorry, 5 giga. So we use prefixes. For what we use prefixes? Just to limit the number of digits we want to write. Okay. So these are the prefixes you have learned before, right? But in there are too many here, a lot. But the one you need to know is the exam they asked is they found up to pico. No need to know femto. From pico up to tera, you have to know. Okay, so up to tera. This two is extra, the femto is extra. Okay, so remember, pico is negative 12, nano is negative 9, micro is negative 6, milli is negative 3. I believe you learned this before. Okay, now we're going to use these prefixes to convert units, okay, quantities. Okay. So remember these prefixes. So I go to the next slide. Okay, now your turn. Use the prefixes, convert these quantities. Let me give you a warm up first. Many people have a different style of doing it. If you get the correct answer, it's good. You go ahead with your method. Let me teach mine. Okay. So how am I supposed to do this conversion first is 1 millimeter squared change to meter squared. So what I do, 1 times, you always put 10. Okay, you always put 10. Milli, what is the prefixes of milli? Is negative? Negative 3. Put the negative 3. Then always minus, remember, always minus meter. Meter don't have prefix, you know. Meter don't have prefixes, just without prefixes. So it's 0. Okay. No prefixes, we put 0. Meter. Meter is 0. So because it's square, we square this power square. So the answer is 1 times what? 10 to the power of negative 3, 2 become negative 6 meter square. So this is the answer. Okay. My way of doing. You might have lots your ways. Okay. So what do you do? Take the prefix of the first unit, then always minus to put the second prefixes. If it's square, square it. The power need to be squared. Okay. So try B now. 1 centimeter squared change to meter squared. So conversion is very important in Cambridge. They purposely give a very weird units. So you have to convert to SI. Although you know how to do the question, if conversion wrong, all gone. Okay, B is what? Anyone got the answer? 1 × 10⁻⁴.
Negative four.
Four meter squared. So 1 × 10⁻¹. So centi is -2. Always minus meter is 0. Because it's square, we square the prefixes. So -2, 2 become -4. Okay, so that's one type term for it. Next, C.
1 times 10 to the negative of 9.
Negative of?
9.
9, very good. Negative 9. Take care. So 1 times 10 to the power of millimeter, negative 3. Meter is 0. Because it's cube, so we cube the power. So become 9, negative 9. D.
10 times 10 power of negative 6.
Negative 6, yeah. Meter cube. Okay. So do the same way as we did earlier. This one, kilometer to meter square.
Negative 6. Power 6.
Times 10 power of 6. Yeah. Meter square. This 1 times 10 to the power of kilo. Kilo prefix is 3. Always minus 0 again meter. So, square. Okay. Done.
1 times 10 power of 9.
9. Okay. Thank you. So, 1 times 10 power of 3. Kilo minus 0. Power of 3. We get this answer. Okay, so this conversion, my style of doing is the 10, you have to put the 10 power of the first prefixes number, always minus with the second prefixes number. If the unit got square, then square it. If unit no square, no need to square it. If it's cube, cube it. Okay, let's go for a little tougher one. This is one more. Okay, we go to the little challenging one. Okay, oh, your turn. 2 minutes. Please convert all of this. What do you need? What do you need? You want? Yeah, the unit conversion is given. Centimeter change to meter, milliampere change to ampere, meter change to centimeter. Please change accordingly. Come on. 2 minutes for you. Okay. Remember the prefixes, You have to recall back the prefixes. So, first one is centi to meter. So, it's what? 100 times 10 to the power of centi is what? Negative
2.
Always minus. Meter is 0. Oh, that's all. Because no power. So, it's what? 100 times 10 power of negative 2. Negative 2. But this is not a scientific notation. Can you put in scientific notation?
1 to the power of negative 4.
Negative 4 or 0? 0.
0.
0, yeah. So 0. The number gets smaller, the power gets bigger. The unit is a meter. I prefer you give me all in the scientific notation. That means This digit must be 0 to less than 10. Single digit, right? Should be single digit. Okay, second one. Times 10 power of mega kilo mega 6. Minus ampere 0. So yeah, final is what? 5.2 times 10 power of
7.
Seven. Number gets smaller, the power rises. 52 become 5.2, so number gets smaller, the power will rise. So last one. ampere. To the next one. This is the training conversion, very important for physics. 0.03 times 10 to the power of meter. Meter zero, always minus centi. Centi is what? Centi is -2. So end up getting 0.03 times 10 to the power of 2. So finally,
three
times 10 to the power of 0, so 3 centimeter. Of course, easier way to shift these two places. I'm just focusing to my technique so that is can be used for everything. Next for D. For this case, how do you convert to second to nanosecond? So 2.0 times 10 to the power of -9. You leave the entire number like that. You don't do anything. You just add another 10 to the power of. Okay, you add another 10 to the power of. Second, how much? Second, no prefixes, so it'll be 0. Always minus nano. Nano, what is the prefix? Nano is -9. So you get your prefixes. So you get what? 2. You get 2.9 nanosecond. Okay, so I just want the answer. E. Millimeter to kilometer. A millimeter to kilometer. Anyone? You mean scientific notation?
Ten power of negative.
Negative?
Six.
Negative six, We got negative six. Kilometer. Negative six. So it's correct, Negative six. Milli change to kilo, So 10 to the power of -3 minus 3, so become -6. Okay. So your F. You mean scientific notation? 2.8. Yeah. Times 10 to the power of what?
-1.
All of you got -1. Microgram. The others, if you got any answers, you just tell me. Then we go and check. So is it -1? Milli is -3. Minus micro is -6. You got -9. Just move up. Is it -1? Milligram is -3. -1. It's -1, correct. Next. G.
3.28. 10 power of 9,
centimeter. Mega 9, mega 6. 6 minus 2, 11. 11. Not 11. Is it 9?
Yes.
9. Mega, huh? Mega is 6. Yeah, 6. Yeah, correct. 9. Next.
3.x6.
Yeah. Time?
Times 10 power of 6.
10 power of 6, eh? 6 nanosecond. Nanosecond, everyone. Okay, next.
6.43.
6.43
times 10 power of negative 4.
Negative 4. Okay, this is a little tricky one. J, you have to convert 2. So, how do you convert this? You convert 1 by 1. 120, you convert kilometer first to meter. How do you do? Times 10 to the power of
3.
Okay. But the per hour, we make it positive. So it's, we put it down as hour, we make it positive. So we assume here like 1 hour. It's like 1 hour. Okay. So if you negative it, bring it down. They bring it down. Now here what happened? 120 times 10 to the power of 3 meter. The 1 hour changed to second. The 1 hour, the bottom 1 hour changed to second.
3,600.
3,600, sorry. And you get the final answer in meter per second. So what do you got? 120 times 10 power 3 divided by 3,600. Anyone? 3,600,
3.33 times 10.
At the power of? I think. 3.33 times 10 to the power of? Nothing. Yeah?
One. Okay.
So my advice, if you got negative, just make the power as positive. Bring it down. Then you put a 1 here. So you just need to change this law, 1 hour. 1 hour change to second at the bottom. It just feel at the bottom. Up is settled. Okay. Okay, K, last one. Do the same thing. 4 gram change to kilogram. So 4 times 10 to the power of gram change to kilogram. What do you do? Gram is 0, no prefixes. Minus kilo is 3. Okay, this is gram change to kilogram. Kilogram. And you can start another prefix to change to centimeter to meter also. Centimeter is what? 10 to the power of? 10 to the power of? Negative 2. Okay. Minus meter. Meter is 0. Mm-hmm. But because the power is negative 3, so we have power we put negative 3. That's my style of doing. Okay. 110 for each prefix, each unit. Okay. This one to convert from gram to kilogram. This one is to convert from centimeter cube to meter cube. You can now use your indices method. Finally, what do you get? 4 times. The first one is what? 10 to the power of?
2.
Negative.
Negative 3. Okay. Times. The other one? Negative 2 times negative 3 is 6.
Negative 6.
2 times negative 3, yeah. So 6. Finally, what do you get? 4 times 10 power of?
3.
3, yeah. 3 kg per meter cube. Okay, this is the, I think the last two is quite the complex one. You got 2. So you must know how to use prefixes, conversion, and finally put the scientific notation. Okay. Okay. Last two, then we stop. I'll be seeing back later at 12 o'clock. But before that, another two, eh? Okay, I go to the next file. Okay, please convert for me these two. I clear this, eh? Okay, please try to convert these two for me to scientific notation. Tell me the final answer. In SI units, SI base units. So this, what unit should be? Centimeter SI unit is, should be meter.
Meters per second.
So yeah, we wanted this to be meter per second. And this, we want it to be kg per meter cube. Okay, give me the final answer. This one is what? 5.21 times 10 to the power of?
8.6.
Oh, sorry, I made a mistake. How much you get?
8.6 times
10 to the power of?
10 power of negative 8.
Negative 8. Okay. So all of you got 8.6 times 10 to the power negative 8. Okay. So next one. Ten power of nine, eh? Okay. So all of you got these two answers. Anyone got a different answer?
So, okay. I have a question.
Yeah.
How to determine whether I need to use how many decimal places?
Oh, good. Okay. The value give 3SF, you have to follow significant figure. This is how many significant figure? Three significant figure. So your final answer also must be 3 significant. Sorry, so 8.6 something. This is how many significant figure? This is, we can go like 5 significant figure or 6, sorry, 6 significant figure.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So your final answer also must be, in reality, must be 6. So 2.31168. So follow the significant figure. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
But your Cambridge, yeah, follow the, retain the same significant figure. Okay, so this is today's class, this session. Next scalar vector we will be doing maybe later. Okay, so I hope you can expose to the documents from the times. Any problem you face in times, everyone can access to times. Okay, everyone can access to times, right? Anyone have problem with accessing to the times? So everything is in times, you know, the notes. I put 1 minute the first topic, okay, 2 minutes the second topic. So all topics will have how many documents? 3 documents. PowerPoint, Word file. Word file is like a summary notes. There will be some empty spots here and there for the summary notes you have to fill up. The PowerPoint is like a complete one, long version. You can use the PowerPoint to fill up the Word file. Okay. And you have questions. Okay. Any question for today's class? So what you learned today? which just recall back like what you learned before. Eh? Homogeneity, I think something new. You never learned before. So to check the equation. And prefixes, you learned before. Just recall back. Okay, the technique. Okay, the last part of the topic, we will cover, finish this topic today. It's a scalar and vector. We will be doing at 12 o'clock. Okay. Scalar and vector can be challenging. Okay. It's not as what you learned last time. Here, slightly extra. Okay. We have to draw a vector diagram. Okay. All of you took additional maths. Anyone without additional maths? So, yeah, shit. Marwan, eh? Okay, good. So, yeah. So, I go a little slowly. Lah, eh? Those who are took additional maths, I think the method I'm going to teach you should be easier. Modern maths, do you learn vectors? Eh? You learn vectors and eh? Modern maths. No, eh? Additional maths, you learn vectors, right? So those who learn additional maths might be this part could be easier. But anyway, I go slowly so that you can catch up. Eh? Okay, I stop here. So I see you at 12 o'clock. Yeah, at 12 o'clock, we continue with this vector scale. Okay. Okay, see you then. Any questions?
No.
No questions. Eh? Okay then. See you. See you later. At 12 o'clock. Yeah, the recording, I'll be put it on the Moodle. Thanks.